It's the Halloween special. This bathroom's so versatile.
We ask your cooperation in helping keep our theaters clean. Please deposit all containers and litter in trash receptacles located in the theater. Thank you.
And now, on with the show.
Are we rarely using the same gag as last Halloween? Yes, it's Halloween once again on the Mondo Squalido channel, even though that really wasn't a big thing until last Halloween. But anyway, today we're looking at another horror film. It's another Italian horror film, and it's by a director I've covered here many times before, and one I will continue to cover in the future. Like me, a lot of you guys will appreciate his work, but I know there are a few of you guys who really don't like this director at all. But for me, this is probably one of his best films, and yeah, let's just get on with the video. So Hell of the Living Dead is Bruno Mattei's zombie masterpiece from 1980. Now, Dawn of the Dead elitists and film snobs might want to turn this video off right now because you will not enjoy what I have to say about this film. But fellow trash hounds who can appreciate good old-fashioned cheesy sleaze, you're going to enjoy this episode, hopefully. Talk is cheap, so why don't I just shut the fuck up? Our film opens up on an offshore nuclear power plant. With funky intro music. And it looks like things are running smoothly.
All readings normal, Professor. Everything checks out.
Oh, wait. It gets infinitely worse. And it's such a shame because they seem like really nice guys.
I'm not surprised with that cute little ass.
I'm a tit man myself.
So, shit has really hit the fan. Well, to be honest, when you call the project
Operation Sweet Death,
I'm not really surprised. Oh well, let's cut to a good old-fashioned hostage situation.
Listen to me, you bastards. I've decided to kill everybody.
This seems like a perfect job for Mike London and the not-quite-Dawn of the Dead players.
Just be careful you don't get your balls wasted.
When did you start worrying about our balls, Daddy?
Sure, they're a ragtag bunch, but they get the job done. And it's time for a good old-fashioned lads' holiday.
What happened to all those cute little wild naked native girls you promised us?
There's one right in front of you, look.
Let the stock footage begin.
She may not seem like much to you, but in bed she's out of this world.
We're then introduced to a family who are also on vacation.
Bringing a 7-year-old child through this filth. Only you could have thought of it.
Accompanying them is a reporter named Leah and her cameraman Max.
I want to immortalize you. Your public won't be happy without a few close-ups.
As they're looking round, zombies happen. Even child zombies. The pair escape, just as Lieutenant Mike London appears with his band of merry men. And once again, they do what they do best.
I get the first shot!
And one of the soldiers, Santoro, works something out.
All you have to do is shoot it right through the head.
The group hightail it out of there, but not before Santoro has to remind his fellow soldiers that
the head!
Oh look, more stock footage. As they're driving, Mike cooks up a plan.
We'll have to ditch them someplace. Like that village you mentioned. That'll be okay, don't worry.
The group arrive near a small tribal village.
I don't like the sound of those drum beats. I wouldn't want to finish up on a spit like chickens at a backyard barbecue.
Leah, utilizing her experience with tribes, decides to
go ahead and meet them, and go alone.
You've got to get tits in there somehow. So after some more stock footage, noticing a theme here, Leah gains the tribe's trust. And after some more stock footage, the group are welcomed, and the party begins. Things are going great. and Leah gets her flirt on.
Couldn't you stop acting in that formal manner of yours?
But of course...
Back to the jeep!
The group escape. But the next day...
Goddamn friggin' son of a bitch!
With tensions rising, there are some strong words.
Oh, son of a bitch!
A minor scuffle.
I'll show you!
And some smart mouthing.
And in case you got the idea that a woman would be afraid to shoot you.
Later that night, and after that potentially ugly situation, Lena gets her flirt on once again.
And we liked each other. We'd be in this act together by now.
That's your opinion.
But Mike wants his boys to have a clean head.
Damn fool. You're supposed to be on guard duty.
Oh well, the next day, wild stock footage appears. And the group make a stop for some water. Until menacing butterflies and zombies ruin that too. Max grabs his camera to get some potentially juicy footage.
That's it, boys. Hold still for a nice close-up.
And once again, poor old Santoro has to point out that...
You need to hit their heads! I told you! See? Like this!
And then proceeds to go all John Rambo.
Get away! Beat it!
They escape, and we're treated to some worldwide political unrest.
And in the meantime, security...
As well as some questionable and rather un-PC dubbing.
The only way to kill them is a bullet right through the head. That's the only way to stop them.
Oh well, they could have used 1930s Disney black voice, I suppose. Let's lighten the mood.
Whee! Oh my god! Damn it! I don't think that's funny!
The group stumble across an abandoned house. After looking around, and of course dressing up... There's a few nasty surprises. And of course... And in all the excitement, it seems that Santoro has completely forgotten his own advice. With one man down, they eventually escape.
In the car.
And Santoro must be losing his mind. After more stock footage, driving, and Santoro going even more insane, the group happen upon a boat.
Do I know how to navigate? I was practically born on a fishing boat.
And after being kindly waved off by zombies, they may be brainless, but they're not heartless. They find themselves at the abandoned nuclear power plant, where things get a little more exciting. But there's too much fun to be had, so I'm going to leave this review right here. Trust me, you will thank me in the end. Okay, I won't show you that, but since you asked really nicely, let's see how things are going back in normal society. Oh shit. Hell of the Living Dead is one of the most entertaining, so bad it's good piece of just plain absurd Italian exploitation. I've missed a hell of a lot out in this review because, quite frankly, every minute seems to have something either batshit insane, something unintentionally hilarious. It's just one big compilation of great, memorable moments. Picture Hell of the Living Dead as a compilation or mixtape of the zombie genre, and then in the hands of Bruno Mattei. There is stock footage by The Bucket Load, tracks from Dawn of the Dead and Contamination have been lifted, which actually led to some legal battles from the Goblin Camp. There are just so many insane and politically incorrect moments in this film, but at the same time, it's full of great zombie action. There's some really great gore and nasty moments. Sure, the zombies look really funny for the most part, but even a classic like Dawn of the Dead had some very questionable zombies. This is one of those films that I can watch time and time again. I really enjoyed revisiting it for this review, And chances are I can watch this a couple more times by the end of this year. It's just a film that I find entertaining from start to finish.
Come on, I said, where?
It's just a film that you can watch that you don't take too seriously. You watch it for what it is, a blatant cash-in, a blatant rip-off, just Bruno Mattei at his finest, in my opinion. And this is one of those films that if you're a horror fan or just a fan of Italian exploitation, you should have seen this already. Do yourselves a favour, check out this film straight away. It's available from Blue Underground on both DVD and Blu-ray, and you're going to have a hell of a lot of fun with this one. Unless you are a film snob or Dawn of the Dead elitist who takes themselves way too seriously. Thank you guys for watching this episode of Mondo Squalido, the Halloween special. I hope you enjoyed it. If you've seen this film, as always, let me know your thoughts and opinions. What's your favourite Bruno Mattei film? If you want to see some of my other Bruno Mattei reviews, I'll be putting those in the description box, as well as a whole load of resource material to find out more about this film. It's just a great film, and it's one of those films that gets better with age, in my opinion. I love this film just as much as the first time I was blown away by it. At the end of this video, you'll see a list of names. I've got the system now where I pick two films randomly, post them into the Facebook group, and let people decide. If you want to get involved in that and get a little bit of a shout out and have your link in the description, then check out the Mondo Squalido Facebook group. Thank you to everyone who decided which film I should review today. It seemed perfect to have this as a Halloween episode as well, so great timing. Thank you guys for watching, and no matter what you're doing on Halloween, stay safe, have fun, and I shall see you in the next review. See you later, guys.
Don't let it worry you. I think you will all meet again. In hell!